sick about everything. Maybe it's in his heart, or maybe it's in his head. He often prays for people like him in the hospitals where it feels so grim. He tries to put the light of hope within. His parents, they don't understand why he gives his time for.
When you hear the expression Le Tiers knife, you may think of knives like these from Chambriard's classic Le Tiers family. But there are a few French cutlery companies that have their very own interpretation of this knife pattern. Welcome to my review of the Tiers liner lock by the French cutlery company Claude Dosomme. If you have watched my video on Chambriard's Le Compagnon, you may remember how this knife pattern came to be. In 1994, the cutlers of the city of Thiers established the Brotherhood of the Thiers Knife. The goal was to create a knife that would reflect the city's long tradition of cutlery. In the following years, quite a few knife makers and cutlery companies came up with some very innovative variations of this knife pattern. And one of these companies is Claude Dosomme. Before we get into the details of this knife, let's take a look at the Claude Dosomme catalog. The company is a family business that was founded in 1902 by Blaise Dosomme in Thiers. The founder was called the Wolf, which is still reflected in the company's logo. The company Claude Dosomme is recognized as Maître Coutelier and received the prestigious label Entreprise du Patrimoine Vivant. What immediately catches your eyes when you open the catalog is the combination of tradition and modernity. Claude Dosomme offers Laguiole and Thiers knives with a minimalistic approach and a touch of high-tech. The characteristic features are still there, like the overall shape and the Laguiole B, but they modernized the overall design and added features like a liner lock and a pocket clip. Here are the models with the black finish. This is the knife we will be looking at today. As you can see, it's also available with other handle materials. The Thiers Verrou comes with an innovative locking mechanism. Here we've got an interesting Laguiole knife with a black blade and a leather handle. But Claude Dosomme also manufactures the traditional Laguiole and Thiers knives, as you can see here, and they make them on a very high level of craftsmanship. Plus, they do all kinds of table and kitchen knives. Now for today's knife, the Thiers liner lock with an all-black finish and two pieces of olive wood. One decorates the pivot, and the other one is a minimalistic approach to a handle scale. The idea of a folding knife where the closed blade, and the cutting edge in particular, are not fully covered by the handle, this design idea is not completely new. Several other knife companies have experimented with this design. For example, there are several CRKT models that come with this kind of design. Also, there is another Le Tiers knife by Fontenay-Pateau that is designed in a similar way. But still, it's a fresh approach to the Le Tiers knife pattern. Let's quickly go over the specs. The closed length is 10.7 cm. The overall length is 18.6 cm. The blade length is 8 cm. And the blade thickness is 2 mm. The weight comes in at 49 grams, so it's really a lightweight knife. Let's compare it to the other Le Tiers knives that I showed at the beginning of this video. This is Chambriard's Le Compagnon, which is slightly larger. And this is Chambriard's Le Compact. So the Thiers liner lock is somewhere between these two sizes. The blade steel is X50 CR MOV 15. It's a German stainless steel with a very cryptic name. I won't go into the details of the chemical composition here, you can easily look it up. The main characteristic of this steel is the high stain resistance. This steel is also used by Victorinox and Wüsthof for their high-end kitchen cutlery. It's not the best steel in terms of edge holding though, but it's very easy to sharpen. The blade is flat ground and came razor sharp out of the box. The black finish is a Teflon-like coating. I'm not sure how the coating will hold up over time, but anyway, this is a knife I will definitely not abuse. The blade comes with both Le Thiers logos, the name Le Thiers, and the little T inside a square. Usually this small version of the logo is stamped in the head of the back spring of a regular Le Thiers knife, as you can see here. However, this is not a slip joint, so there is no backspring, it's a liner lock. And just with any other liner lock, you disengage the blade by pressing on this part of the liner. You could probably also call it a frame lock, since there is only this one piece of metal which forms the liner or frame of the knife. Basically, there are three pieces of metal. The blade, the liner, and the pocket clip. The knife is a screw together construction. There are four screws, two for the wooden handle scale, one screw that works as a blade stop, and finally, the pivot screw. Although the knife is so thin and the overall construction may look a little fragile, the lockup is pretty decent. As I already mentioned, this is not a knife you would want to abuse. After all, it's a gentleman's knife for light-duty cutting tasks. There is a detent ball at the top of this part of the liner, and there is a hole in the tang. So once the knife is closed, it cannot open accidentally. Also, the cutting edge is not exposed at all, so there is no way of cutting yourself. The handle provides a full four-finger grip. Since it is very thin, it is not the most comfortable handle, but again, this is not a knife you use for hours at a stretch. What appeals most to me about this knife is the combination of extreme opposites. There is the classic knife pattern with the traditional handle material, and on the other hand, there is this industrial look with this black-coated steel. I usually don't like black-coated blades and anything tactical, but this knife looks so cool I just couldn't resist. Of course, this is not a tactical knife by any means. You can make it look like a tactical knife, but in fact it's a non-aggressive, elegant gentleman's knife that you can wear with a suit. That's it. I hope you enjoyed my short introduction to Claude Dausomme knives in general and my review of this black Thiers liner lock in particular. Thanks for watching and take care.